Welcome back to my channel, friends. I'm so glad that you're here. Thank you so much for joining me for June monthly favorites. I am always the one that goes, I can't believe that June's over. But you know what? June dragged on for me. And I don't know why, other than we have just been in this quarantine situation. And I am one that stays home anyway. So this has been a double stay at home order for me. But anyway, hopefully we can all get back to the normal soon and try to adjust to what our new normal is, right? It's kind of weird, everything that's going on and how we've had to kind of rethink, being a consumer, being a shopper, everything like that, and so many things being done online. Now, I have some absolutely fantastic products that I have been loving this month. Some of them I've just been trying. Some of them I've talked to you guys about a little bit. Some of them I haven't mentioned at all. So we're going to get right into this and see what I was loving for the month of June. I have a huge basket, you guys. So let's get into this so that we can get through it in such a timely manner that it won't take up half the day. Okay, let's start out with what I have on my eyes today. I actually used two palettes, but I have three to share with you. These are the new ones that came out from ColourPop. I don't know when, but not very long ago. These are the In a Trance is this one right here, and this one is Miss Bliss. Now, first I'm gonna tell you that they are the plastic packaging with the mirror, which I love. So it's the 9-pan palettes. And I used this row right here over on my eyes today. So I did the pinks over here. I have been using the peaches a lot. My looks have really trended towards very summery colors for the past few months and lightening up my makeup quite a bit. So I've really been enjoying that. And then this one that is In a Trance from ColourPop has the pinks. And then these are purples right here. And again, you guys, it has that stupid glitter in both of them in the middle. I think what I'm gonna start doing with those is I'm gonna take that pan completely out and pop something else in there from another palette that I may have been, getting rid of because I didn't like the total palette, but I liked the color, and just pop another color in there. So I think that maybe is what I'm gonna do. But anyway, I really like both of these for being such bright, cheery, beautiful colors that you can wear on your eyes and it just be very wearable, very easy to just pop on one or two colors and then go about your day. But the one thing that I will say is that when I did use those colors right there, that I didn't find a dark enough color to be able to put in my outer V. So what I did was I took the Milani Most Loved Mattes, which, oh my gosh, I love these palettes, you guys. And I promised that I would do a tutorial, and I'm still going to. But I went in with this color right here on my outer V, which is kind of just a deepened plum color to go along with the pink. And I love the way that the look turned out today. So all three of those palettes I really do love. This is one that is discontinued. You guys hop on that train because they are still on Amazon, and they actually are, some of them still are on the Milani website, but I don't know how long that's going to be that way. So really like all three of these palettes. And I should have started with skincare, but I didn't. But I am going to tell you guys what I've been really enjoying and really been appreciating, and that is the Vitamin C Serum. This is from Hada Labo, and it's the Deluxe Vitamin C Serum. And there's a lot in there, you guys, quite a few ounces in there. And I think that this is a really good vitamin C serum. I love Hada Labo's products anyway, but I think that this vitamin C serum is great. It's very essence-like, toner-like. So you're going to want to use it as one of your very first steps, which I think is really good. But yeah, it's just one of those ones that I've been loving and using a lot as I get towards summer and I'm outdoors a little bit more, and I want to make sure my face is protected with the antioxidants, and I really love this. However, there is a tiny scent in here, you guys. It's just so slight. It really just does smell like a lemon peel, but it's a tiny, tiny scent in there, just so you know that. But I did want to tell you guys, and you'll see this pop up in another video. This is from Skin Aqua. This is their Super Moisture Essence with an SPF of 50 plus, and then it has 4 PA pluses on the end of it. And I have been using the one in the blue, the little blue bottle or the little blue tube like this. Love that stuff for it being a hydrating SPF. But I was feeling like it was getting just a little bit too much as we're transitioning into the hotter months. So I tried this one and I love it. It's really lightweight. It sinks into the skin really easily and really quickly. And it's a pretty big tube. So I haven't been minding putting this on the back of my hands or on my shoulders and, you know, kind of really just slathering it in. So really have been enjoying that one as well. And then want to share with you two primers that I am absolutely in love with right now. This one is from Hard Candy. This is one that has been around a while, but this is the Pore Defense Primer. And it says it's oil-free and silicone-free. So how do you get the blurring effect if it says if it's a silicone-free primer and oil-free? And I don't know, but I do know that it's beautiful across the skin. And I have it on today all over the skin. And I just think it makes such a pretty canvas. And it really does help to blur out my pores really well and really cost-effective. And you can pick that one up at Walmart. Make sure that I link that one for you guys. But I also got the Misha. Love Misha as a brand. They're usually on Amazon. You can't really find them too many other places. Maybe Yes Style, maybe. I'll make sure that I link it for you. But anyway, this is their illuminating primer. This one is really a beautiful primer, you guys. This one gives the most beautiful, soft glow on the skin. And it has definitely fragrance. If you've ever tried Misha before, they use fragrance. They're a Korean beauty brand that doesn't mind using fragrance, but hopefully you guys can see a little bit of the sheen. Can you see a little bit of the sheen on that hand? It's just beautiful underneath makeup. Sinks in really well, and yet it has a little bit of a hydrating property to it that I can feel. So I really have been enjoying that. But if you are somebody that can't do fragrances, then definitely, you know, steer clear of this one. But I wanted to make sure I told you about it because I just think it gives just the prettiest glow. All right, speaking of glow, there are so many glow products in here, you guys. I'm just like, this is crazy, Melissa. I don't know if you guys remember or not, but I had a glowing tutorial. Glowing tutorial, that sounded weird. I had a video where I was talking about getting a glowing look, and I used the Essence Pure Nude highlighters. This one is Be My Space Light. The other one is Be My Highlight. And I used them on my eyelids, and I had talked about wanting to get this palette from them that had the four different, oops, sorry, that's a mirror. Yes, it does have a nice mirror in it. For $10, okay, I got this palette. It's basically called Pure Nude Highlighter Palette. So it has the four different colors. They are so pretty, you guys, and they are that same consistency, maybe just a little bit softer, which actually lends itself to blending a little bit better, but you have a pink, a gold, a yellow, and kind of a peach color up in there, and I just think it's so, so pretty, and I've been using these a lot across my eyes because this is just brightness. It's just sheer brightness with a tiny bit of shimmer, and it is so good for mature eyes. So if you guys like those other two, or you like the Essence Pure Nude Highlighter, I think that you're gonna love this. I fell in love with it, and I've just been keeping it in my makeup bag in case there is a palette where I just don't find a light enough highlighter or a light enough lid color to be able to bring brightness without bringing too much metallic. So I'm in love with that, you guys. Another glow product that I found is the Milani. This is their highlighter duo, and this one is in Supercharged. This is a really beautiful highlighter, and I've been wearing it a lot. Now, this side is supposed to be cream, and then this side is supposed to be the powder. Now, I will say that the cream doesn't feel much like a cream. What it feels like is a Super Shock shadow from ColourPop. And so I'll just kind of swatch those right there for you too. I'm the worst swatcher, you guys. But it is so pretty. Those are just some next level beautiful highlights. This one is the cream is a super soft incandescent. And then this is more like the Becca highlighters that are the pressed one. It's just a really, really beaming highlighter. So a really glowing highlighter. But I like both of them. And these come in a few different colors. I think three, maybe four colors. So this one is more along the lines of the pink, which is my coloring. But if you like peaches or just the icy colors, they did have a few others of those. Now, I told you guys about Sydney Grace and how much I'm in love with her powder. I picked up the other one, the other powder, which is this is supposed to be medium. So let me show you the fair. This is the fair, which is just like a white color, okay? So that is the fair one that I've been using all month. And then this one came a few days ago, which is the medium. And you know what, you guys? If I dip into the lids, you know, you kind of turn these over, dip into the lids of both of them and then do my dusting, it is gorgeous. The color is perfect for me. This is a little bit too much of a color for me, but the two together are perfect. But this powder is made of mica, and it's absolutely 100% a dupe for the Hourglass Veil Mineral Powder, 100%. So if you guys have been looking for something to try as far as Hourglass goes, but you can't do that, these are only $14 and I think they're fantastic. And they have like two or three times more product in them than the Hourglass one. So Sydney Grace has my vote for the company that I'm exploring right now and that I'm absolutely in love with. If you get the chance to, please try some of her stuff. Now look at this highlighter, you guys. Isn't that gorgeous? Okay, I put this highlighter on underneath my blush before I did my blush and it still shone through so pretty. So I need to show you guys this highlighter. She has pressed highlighters and she has just the loose highlighters, but I got the loose one because I thought, well, maybe this would be better for me. And you guys, what is this color, by the way? Let me find out. Pink Lightning. You guys, this is some Beyond Highlighter Highlightness. It is so pretty. Oh my word. Take a look at that. Oh my gosh. Why is my whole video about June about highlights? I have so many products, but this Sydney Grace one, tons of highlighter in here. This is gonna last you a really long time because all I did was put this on with a fan brush and holy moly, look at the glow. And no texture, it's very, very light, airy. Didn't feel like it settled into my pores, my larger pores that I have. So pretty, you guys. I can't say enough about that. It's just really, really gorgeous. So if you've been looking for something as a mature woman that really loves that glow, but she doesn't want to, look at the finger. Oh my gosh. But she doesn't want to get, you know, too much texture on your face, you might try it because I think they're so beautiful. Okay. I am going to show you several things that I have been absolutely appreciating more and more this month. And I've shown you guys these actually a lot in the month. The LA Girl Pro Conceal, this is my peach corrector from them. I haven't found anything that works as good as this because it has a tendency to grip underneath my eyes but not show up any texture. It's creamy enough to not show any texture. I love that, you guys. My Anastasia Beverly Hills eyeshadow primer. This tube has lasted me forever. I mean, I bought this tube before we moved into this house, and we moved into this house back last September. This is just going strong. You just need so very little of it. It completely takes out any redness, any veining, anything like that on my eyes. Grips my eyeshadow like no other. I can't say enough about that. I did a concealer video this month and I fell in love with the e.l.f. Camo Hydrating Concealer. Love this stuff. I think that it performs as good as high-end. And just mine's in light peach. Perfect color for me. I can't say enough good about this because it does last on me all day long. And just really have been enjoying that. Also, these little sticks from e.l.f. that are the multi-sticks. These are so great, you guys. They're used as cream blush. I use them as cream blushes. You can also use them as lipstick or an eyeshadow if you want to. But they're so easy to blend. I think those are great. I actually did just order me two others to try. And then I'm going to talk to you guys about, in the summer, as I'm darkening up my makeup, I'm buying darker foundations, but every single one of them seem to be either way too peach or way too yellow. And this is saving my whole makeup look every single time. It's the LA Girl Mix In Medium in Blue. I'm very cool toned. If you're neutral and you find all of your foundations that are just making you look too yellow, you will have your right tone, so it's not going to look like you're an Oompa Loompa. So that's basically what I'm absolutely loving. And then I know I'm going to get a lot of you asking what's on my lips today. This is something that I've been enjoying a lot too. This is from Essence, and this is their Soft Contouring Lip Liner. This one is in Something for Grey, Sucker for Grey, Gray, not Grey, sorry, Sucker for Grey. And I love these pencils, one, because they're very easy to work with. You can smudge them out if you want to. But I love this color because my cool coloring and how I'm always wearing pink on my lips, this is the perfect liner. I can line outside of my lips and kind of fill in just a little bit. And by the time I'm done with this, I feel like I've got a bigger pout. And then I also have from Dose of Colors, I've got this lipstick a long time ago, but I'm in love with it now. And this is the color Parfait. And I absolutely love everything about this lipstick. I love the texture. I love the color of it. It is matte. It stays on really well. And I do have a gloss over top of it, which is a Fenty gloss, but I really like this. I got it on Ulta's 21 Days of Beauty, I don't know, quite a while ago. But I love these lipsticks. I haven't purchased any more of them because this is a perfect color and trying to use up what I have, but this is so pretty on, and it's just a beautiful, beautiful rosy pink color.
And then I want to tell you about some sprays that I've gotten, some setting sprays, some glowing sprays, different things like that.
This one is not a setting spray. This is from Fourth Ray Beauty, which is ColourPop's sister brand. You can buy this on their website. I don't know if you can get this in Ulta or not yet, but if you can, I'll make sure I link it. This is the Fresh AF. I hate those names, by the way. Mist. And this, it really acts for me a lot like MAC Fix Plus, which is the primer spray that you can use. I love that spray for refreshing my face. I love it to spray my sponge when I'm putting on my foundation, because it just seems to spread everything just so pretty. And I've been using that in place of my Max Fix Plus, and I love this stuff, you guys. It really is a nice mist. It is not a mist that you would want to use as a setting spray. It is not one that is going to keep your makeup on all day. It just won't do that. But if you're having times during the day when you feel like your face is really dry or your makeup needs refreshed, you can spray this on top of it for sure and get a really freshened look to your makeup. I think this is a great spray, and I'm glad I got it. And then two different sprays, one, another one from Hard Candy. I kind of raided the Hard Candy aisle at my local Walmart. This one is their Glow Setting Spray. Really like that one. It really is a beautiful dewy finish. And then the one I have on today is a new one from Maybelline, and this is their Glass Spray. And this one just seems to be one that just makes you look like your skin is so glowy and so dewy and just beautiful. But I will tell you that the sprayer on this is crap, you guys. It's terrible. So I'm going to be transferring this into another bottle, but I really do like the glow spray itself. It just makes you look really pretty and give you kind of a soft candlelight glow to your skin. So I really do like that.
I'm gonna wrap this up with talking about two high-end mascaras that I got. But look at them, guys. These are the little tubes.
So I think that one might have been 11 and one might have been 13. I'll make sure I put that on the screen. But one is from Fenty Beauty. I do know that it's 13. And then the other one is from Anastasia Beverly Hills. And I have the Fenty on this eye and the Anastasia Beverly Hills on this eye. And we can get close. You guys can see what I love about this one from Fenty Beauty. They both do this, but I'll tell you what I love more about the Fenty one. They both separate the lashes and they give you great volume from the root up, and then you can build on them. You know, you can continue to build on them. But the Fenty, I can build on this even after it's dry.
It makes a beautiful eyelash look.
I absolutely love this. I love the Anastasia one too, but I think the Fenty one kicked its butt because I actually do like this brush just a little bit more. Now, if you look at it right there, it just looks like, you know, typical, I don't know, wide and then tapered brush, but it is thinner. So you can get into your eyes and kind of, you know, make sure you get those inner ones, make sure you get those outer ones. So I like that.
The Anastasia Beverly Hills one is very much like all of the other Hourglass ones that are on the market right now.
It's not anything different. I do like that it's a little bit more of a natural bristle instead of the rubber ones that you get, but I do think I like the Fenty one a little bit better than this. But either one are really good.
But I think the Fenty one might last longer. I haven't noticed any smudging or any flaking from either one of them. Both of them, you can't go wrong, but the Fenty ones seem to just make those lashes fan out so much, and it's so easy, and they're soft. They don't feel like, you know, sometimes you can get a mascara on and you feel like it's cracking your eyelashes. It doesn't feel like that. It's really soft, makes it still feel really soft. And so I love in both of those. I'll have them both on at the end of the day when I'm done with my makeup. So that's it for today's video, you guys. I hope that you did enjoy this monthly favorites. I know that I had a lot packed in here and I kind of talked really fast, which is kind of what I always do, but I hope that you guys did enjoy this. Let me know in the comment section below if there's any of these products that you've tried and that you love, or ones that you have tried and you hate. I'd love to know that too, you guys. Thanks so much for being with me today. Everybody, please stay safe, stay hydrated, stay sanitized, and I will catch you all in my very next video. Love you. Bye, guys.